Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to this month's Commander's Corner. It's the 15th of April, 2013. I hope you got your income taxes done, and it's also a payday, so a double whammy today. A few things to talk about to you here. To begin with, from the last two weekends, we've done good on the drinking and driving. We've gotten no DUIs or no DWIs the last two weekends. Let's keep that trend going. We did have a couple knuckleheads engage in the ignorant oil too much over the weekend and get in trouble in other aspects, but at least we didn't have any drinking and driving. So let's keep that trend up. This week on the 17th of April is going to be the STEM conference. That's science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. That's going to be held this week. So I think we're going to talk a little bit more about that later on in the show, but that's an event that we've been looking forward to. An event I've been looking forward to this Thursday afternoon. CFAY is going to play hooky again. Go do the CFAY at the Bay Stars game. The Yokosuka Bay Stars are playing the Lions. Game starts at 2 o'clock. I've authorized an alternate work site for all the CFAY personnel. I hope many of the other tenant commands are going to follow suit. Weather's supposed to be great. It's supposed to be like 70 degrees and sunny. So come on out Thursday to Apama and catch yourself a Japanese professional baseball game. Also, if you want to help out with the community, this Friday night is our monthly haunch patrol. You can assemble down at Kearney Gate at 10:15 p.m. or 22:15 to us military types, and go out in the community and help pick up some trash with the local authorities and dignitaries. So there's an opportunity to help give to the community. If it gets rained out, which is not supposed to by the weather forecast, it would be postponed to the following week. The commissary is going to be closed next Monday and Tuesday. That's the 22nd and 23rd of April for their annual inventory. They got to go around and count all the cans and count all the beans, I guess, and everything, but they're going to be doing that on the 22nd and the 23rd. Next week, all week long, from the 22nd through the 26th, is Exercise Reliant Gale. That's a typhoon readiness exercise, so we're going to be going through all the different typhoon conditions of readiness because typhoon season's almost here. Geez, just a few days ago we had some heavy winds and we actually set a condition of readiness already. So I'm sure it's coming. We'll probably get hit with two or three of them this year. So it's a good time to use that week to get ready for them and get your emergency kit stocked up and review what the different conditions of readiness means. Road tax. If you haven't paid your road tax yet, you're going to have another chance to do it here on the installation down at the VRO. They'll be here next week. Remember, when you come to pay your road tax, you must have yen. Even if you pay it here on the base, you must have yen to pay your road tax. For all those who have got kids in school and are going to be here next year, mandatory school re-registration is coming up. It's going to be running from April 29th through 2 May, so make sure you re-register your children, or you're going to have to keep them at home with you all day long. So I think you probably want to re-register the kids for school. Yeah, all right. The CNO, the Chief of Naval Operations, is going to be paying a visit to Yokosuka. He's going to hold an all-hands call on the 10th of May. That'll be from 8 to 9 a.m. at Fleet Theater. So if you want to come on out and ask the CNO some questions, you're going to have an opportunity. And on 22 May, it's a little ways off, but I'm going to go ahead and put it out now. We're going to be having our summer safety stand down, so we'll have some presentations and some things to talk about on that you can attend because we're coming up on the summer days of summer. You know, they always call them the 101 critical days of summer. We don't want to have any serious injuries or anything. I'll be playing softball, so we will have injuries this summer. I just don't want to have any really serious injuries this year. Speaking of softball, if you're into softball, the Intramural Softball League starts next week, along with the Intramural Volleyball League. So get your team signed up. They have to be registered by Wednesday. Also, summer camp registration. Registration starts the 22nd of April, so you can come out and get your kids registered for summer camp. And for you runners, the Anchors Away Half Marathon is coming up on the 27th of April. You can do two laps around the base. That's approximately what it is. They do take you over the Vandegrift Hill a couple of times, so make sure you're working out and practicing on that one for the 13.1 miles. There is a registration fee of $15, and you need to be signed up by the 24th of May if you want to do the half marathon. Final thing I'll talk about here before we start getting to guests and taking some breaks is energy conservation. You can see we're hot and heavy on it already with the budget constraints. We've been ordered to take a $2.6 million cut compared to what we did last year. That's why the heat got turned off a little earlier than what it normally did. And I'm sorry. I hope you had enough blankets to stay warm and everything. And you see the street lights we've gone through, and we turned out a lot of the street lights again. We're not operating the fountains. But probably the biggest contributor to saving energy is the community itself. It's with you. Turn lights out when you're not using them. You know, don't crank up the thermostats. Just be smart on your use of energy, and we can make that goal and not have to get slapped by the higher authorities if we don't get within the numbers that they've given us. All right, CFAY, we're going to take a break. Then I'm going to be back with some very cool guests.
And now, it's time for A Few Too Many with Tommy the Tequila Worm.
Hey there, amigo. You've got some great friends. They bought you drink after drink tonight. And when you passed out at the party, they didn't just leave you there. No way. They made sure that you were safe and sound for the night by duct taping you to a park bench. Not cool, bro.
Don't be that guy!
Welcome back, CFAY. I've got my first of the guests here right now. I've got Chief Rose from CFAY. He is the CFAY DAPA, and this is Alcohol Awareness Month. So what can you tell me here, Chief? Welcome to the show.
Sir, thank you, sir. April is actually National Alcohol Awareness Month. It's not just a Navy push. It's actually a national push to increase the awareness of the use of alcohol. We want to promote cell health and want to promote healthy and safe choices when it comes to the use of alcohol. CFAY is doing a couple things. First off, I'm here talking to you and helping talk to the community about this. I'm also using various social media to talk about this. Lastly, we're actually using Sailors. CFAY's Coalition of Sailors Against Destructive Decisions is working to help spread the word. As a matter of fact, last weekend we had several sailors from CFAY went ahead and took a pledge not to drink alcohol. And I'm going to be talking about that in various social media during the month, sir.
Okay, cool. So we got a lot of events going on for the alcohol awareness. It's almost like alcohol awareness, abuse prevention is what it is that we're talking about. Just not everybody knows what alcohol is, so we're not trying to make everybody aware of it. I know they know where it's at and everything. We've had several DUIs and DWIs this year, unfortunately, already. And we've had some other people make some poor choices while liquored up on ignorant oil. Is there still designated driver programs around?
Yes, sir. As a matter of fact, every club here on base that serves alcohol has a designated driver program. You just identify yourself to the club manager or the service staff, and what they'll do is the designated driver actually drinks for free, or drinks non-alcoholic beverages for free, and also gets a free t-shirt.
Okay, oh, the t-shirt. Oh, that's cool. You get a free t-shirt. I'm the designated driver. All right, is there any other events going on for the month, or is that pretty much cover it?
That pretty much covers what we're doing for this month, yes, sir.
All right, remember, I don't say don't drink at all. I say drink responsibly. Let's not have any more incidents out there. I mean, you can ruin a career pretty quick. What some people don't know is there's actually a movement out there. I've seen a memo to make a DUI mandatory processing for discharge if you're on active duty. I don't know if it's ever going to come to fruition or not, but this is not something we want to have done. But either way, thanks for being on the show, Chief. We're going to take another break, then I'm going to have some more cool guests back on the show.
On the 16th of May, we have the amazing Yokosuka STEM Race. This is a culmination between the five Yokosuka schools. So it's Kinnick High School, YMS, Bird Elementary, Ikego, and Sullivan's. And we're looking for a way to bring all the schools together for this one event. So hence the race. And the whole gist of the race is there'll be 10 stations. The student will go to each station and attempt to solve these STEM problems. But basically, we're looking for community members, again, military or civilian, to actually create a STEM problem for the student that they can solve. Yeah, we're trying to get the community involved, and again, it's the 16th of May. It'll be an all-day event. If you want more information, please call 243-5687. And be happy to bring you on board and talk about it.
Okay, welcome back again, CFAY. And as promised, I got some more cool guests here on the show. You know, I mentioned STEM earlier. That's the STEM conference coming up for science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. Well, I got a couple representatives that are going to be involved with that here.
Who do I have here? What's your name, please?
Jack Gilbertson.
Okay, and?
My name's Kyle Gray.
All right, and you're students over at the high school, I assume?
Yes, sir.
All right, and what's this cool thing we got in front of us here?
What we have here is a robot that we have built in Robotics Club. It was built by a team of fellow students, including our main engineer, Kyle, and myself, the pilot. The robot's intended for a competition between the other schools in the kind of the Kanto region. The robot's supposed to pick up a beanbag and lift it up and put it into a bin, either a kind of high bin or a really high bin.
Okay.
And when we went to competition, our robot did pretty well. We came in semifinals. We won a innovation award, and also we were probably the only robot that could reach the high bin, so it was pretty nice.
Pretty cool. So this is you said this is the robotics club. Is this like a class at school, or?
We have a robotics class and a club. If you're interested after taking the class, you can go and take the club, where we go and do competitions with other schools and build robots such as this.
Wow, actual robotics classes at the high school these days.
Yeah.
I was just happy if I had Lincoln Logs in my classroom when I was coming up. This is pretty cool. This is awesome. So can you power this thing up, or?
Yeah, sure.
Let's go for it. Let's see what it can do. That's the award there, right?
Yeah, the Innovation Award.
Even the Innovation Award. Oh, wow.
So the arm's supposed to lift up, of course. And then the... can get pretty high. And then the beanbags are fed in through the cyclone feed.
Uh-huh. Cool.
And then spit out.
Awesome. That's neat. How long did it take you to put this thing together?
We had a lot of models, and it took about,
let's say, 2 months.
About two months to put it together?
Yes.
Wow, that's cool. That's awesome. Yeah. I didn't have anything like that when I was in high school all day.
Nah.
I didn't even have a calculator back then. They were still making them. It was like, I thought it was cool when I got my Texas Instruments when I was in college. So, but this is great. And this is some of the stuff they're going to be talking about and showing you at the conference this week. So if you get a chance to come on out to the conference, this is neat stuff. This is what you're doing today in the high school level. This is what you're going to be doing probably in the middle school level before much longer. I don't know if the middle school has robotics yet, but they probably do. And This is how you get ahead, and this is how you advance. I mean, this is neat stuff to learn. You know, this isn't the hard stuff. This is great. Well, thanks for coming on the show and showing us this stuff.
No problem. Thank you.
All right. Cool.
Okay, CFAY. I'll wrap things up with, of course, the trivia. You can't do anything without the trivia. From the last video I did, I asked a question of trivia, and actually involves this Cracker Jack box right here that I found, because the trivia question was, what's the name of the sailor and the dog on this Cracker Jack box? Of course, if you had the box, it's written right on the box, but the answer was Sailor Jack and Bingo, and Trish Davila gave me that answer. The cool thing is I found this Cracker Jack box. The uncool thing is I found it in a bush while I was walking my dog. That's not how we dispose trash, but that's okay. It came in handy. I found it this morning, actually. I found it this morning. You want to talk about coincidence? That's pretty cool. Now, on to some new trivia. I got a song here. I'll give you the lyrics. Give me the TV show that this song goes to. All these nights when you got no lights, the check is in the mail, and your little angel hung the cat up by its tail. Okay, see if you can figure out which one that is. The next question I have here is, this game, I had this as a kid, this was a precursor to the Transformers. All right, this was a precursor game to the Transformers, one of the inspirations for it. I mean, one of the characters in it was like Optimus Prime, and the other one is Megatron. But that isn't what their names were then. But this game is the precursor to it. And then finally, for my sports one, we got the resurfacing done down around Berkey Field for the track. So I see all these people running, practicing for their PRT. So that led me into coming up with this question. What is the world record for the mile, both male and female? What's the world record for the mile? And I think it's a lot faster than anybody's going to do the PRT for us during the spring season. But either way, that one just came to mind. Well, CFAY, I hope you all have a safe week. And as usual, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. and good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great week, CFAY, and I hope I see a lot of you at the ball game Thursday.